We are constantly surrounded by water. 4/5 of our planet is water. 60% of the human body is water. Water, water, water. It's the building block of life. But what if it was a literal poison to you? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what if you were allergic to water? Before we launch into this video, I just want to remind you guys to hit that thumbs up button and of course to click on the notification bell to be the first to hear a big answer. So there are actually people out there who are allergic to water. The condition is called aquagenic urticaria, and actually, it has medics stumped. They believe it comes from a bad reaction between oily skin cells and water, causing the release of toxic compounds that gives a person a blotchy allergic reaction. The condition is extremely rare, with around 30 current known cases in the world. So if you were allergic to water like sufferers of aquagenic urticaria, you would find the process of drinking incredibly uncomfortable. Humans generally need to drink 2.4 liters of a liquid a day, but for those with a water allergy, this would be very hard indeed. For some reason, drinking milk seems to be somewhat okay to sufferers, so I guess that you'd better not have a dairy intolerance. I imagine your relationship with food in general would be quite different too, staving away from wetter dishes and constantly taking care not to dribble. If you had a water allergy, you would also need to shower a lot less and would need to plan around your cleaning. Currently, people who are allergic to water usually bathe just once a week, and they have to deal with a red rash and hives for hours afterwards. As a result of showering less, I can only imagine those who are allergic to water would invest heavily in dry shampoo, and that avoid situations where they may perspire. Also, perfume would be a no-go. The perspiration is actually an issue unto itself. Those with water allergies are also allergic to their own sweat, so this would make exercising pretty difficult, or just not an option. Problems also come with shedding tears. The watery eyes would cause an uncomfortable allergic reaction, so tear jerkers would be avoided at all costs. Life would be quite an adjustment if you were allergic to water. Perhaps you would live with disposable plates for fear of doing the washing up. You would plan to stay in on a rainy day, but if you were caught short in a downpour, you'd suffer. Speaking of rain, perhaps you'd consider living in a dry location, so avoiding places like the UK, Seattle, or the west coast of Canada. Drier areas like Arizona, for example, may be better suited to water allergy sufferers. Of course, there'd be no swimming, beach vacations, or boats, because that would just be asking for a whole world of pain. Aquagenic urticaria sufferers are regularly pumped up on antihistamines, and carrying them around at all times is pretty essential. Worryingly though, long-term use of antihistamines is linked to dementia, so the problems faced by a person suffering from a water allergy could have some concerning future issues. As I said, water allergies are very rare. Our evolution as species has kind of depended on our development around water, being as it makes up so much of our planet. In searches for other habitable planets out there in the galaxy, water is the number one thing that we look for. Perhaps alien life doesn't need it, perhaps they're deeply allergic to it, like in Signs, who knows, but for us anyway, it's pretty crucial, and it definitely sucks if you can't handle it. So that's right, it certainly sounds like suffering a water allergy would be a bit of a nightmare. I guess it'd be worse if you're allergic to air. What would you guys like us to discuss next on Life's Biggest Questions? Do let me know in the comments section down below. For now, please do leave a thumbs up and share this video with a friend to stay subscribed for more big answers. If you want to continue on your questioning binge, why not check out our biggest science questions and our biggest what ifs?